Heads may well roll. Yes, indeed, they may. And we can bloody well start with that music for a start. Oh my God. Love Hearts. Okay. Love Hearts for preferences. Save game title screen. This was a game that was bought for me by one of my moderators. I am unsure as to how long he is going to remain one of my moderators. I know absolutely nothing about this game except it is called Long Live the Queen, and Pink seems to be involved. And assuming this is my queen, apparently she's been stung by some poisonous type of animal, and her eyeballs have swollen up to be larger than her mouth. I wonder if that will also explain the pink hair. Does she have wings on her head as well? Okay, I mean, I'm trying to figure this out. We've got this, like... Somebody's cut her nose off and just left a tiny little pimple. Her eyeballs are the size of... apples. Apparently she has no eyebrows worth talking about and has had to draw them on with a pencil. Her hair is pink. She looks vaguely like a, I don't know, a six-year-old and yet is wearing... kinky boots, which leads me to believe this game was created by people who were, well, they won't be babysitting for me, let's put it that way. She has a scepter, is that a scepter? There's a scepter, I guess it's a scepter. Love Hearts, of course, more Love Hearts. Copyright 2012, Hanako Games and Spiky Caterpillar. You don't watch much anime, do you, Gopher? Is this anime? Mutant, pink, small children with their noses chopped off. No, I do not watch much of that. Call me strange, call me odd. Not something that has ever really appealed to me. Yeah. So let's start. Oh my God, if this is Hatterful Boyfriend, I am going to kill you, Zelfos. Canada is not far enough away. Jocelyn, King Dowager, Duke of... I'm not even going to say what I thought that said at first. The whole pink thing getting to me here. Caloris, we're almost home. Your room is just the way you left it. A mess and preferably hiding a flamethrower under the bed. Well, what do I do now? Do I hit question mark? King Dowager of Nova, Duke of... there. Age 33. Age 33? Are you kidding me? He cannot be older than 9. He has the same... I have no nose and my eyes have been swollen thing that the Queen has. Is there some affliction hitting the kingdom? Everybody sort of stops aging at 7, doesn't develop a nose, but their eyeballs continue to grow. Okay, but what now? Do I click? I click! Elodie, oh my God, seriously? Somebody's moved her eyes down to where her cheek should be. I mean, these are her eyebrows. This, that, what's that, her nostril? Elodie, crown print. Should I plug my controller in? You know, but would it play better with the controller? Or alcohol, maybe. Oh god. It is, it's Hatterful Boyfriend. Oh my god. Why would you do this to me? Long live the Queen. I was thinking, you know what? I'm going to be Queen of a nation. I'm going to raise up an army and I'm going to destroy my foes. Or political intrigue. I know it's hard to leave your school and all your friends, but I've arranged the best possible tutors for every subject. Oh, God. You'll have to work hard this year to prepare yourself before your 15th birthday, but I know you can do it. You'll learn quickly and you'll make a wonderful queen. It's what your mother would have wanted. Is mother dead? Did her eyes expand so much her skull exploded? Is that what happened? Elodie, Crown Princess, this is not what mother would have wanted. She wouldn't have wanted to die and leave me. Good point. My eyeballs seem to have moved up slightly more. Can my eyes actually move around my skull? Because that would be a kind of cool mutant superpower. Do I have any other superpowers? Apart from, you know, pink. No, she wouldn't, but sometimes bad things happen. We have to pick up and carry on. Did you kill Mother? All of Nova depends on us. On you. Sigh. I will be here to guide you until your coronation. Couldn't you get voice actors for this? Or did everybody refuse? That's probably true. Come, your maids are waiting. Tell me more, I've played this before. If this is your first time playing, you should read this brief introduction on how the game works. Tempted to just go for I've played this before, but fine, tell me more. You will be controlling Elodie, the almost Queen of Nova, as she tries to prepare for her coronation. Can I go and get my 7-year-old to come in and play this? Because I ought to think she'd have a far better time. Actually, I think this is too pink even for her. And my 2-year-old would be busy trying to kill the screen about now. Maybe I should get my 2-year-old in, actually. That'd be even funnier. You'll be controlling Elodie, the almost Queen of Nova, as she tries to prepare for her coronation. To do that, she needs to take classes every week. It's Hatterful Bloody Boyfriend! It really is! It's... I will be back. Gopher is judging this by his cover. No, he's not. He's judging it by this. This is not the cover. I don't believe there is a cover on a digital download. Cheers. You think this is as bad as Every Birdie? Whoa, that was kind of... Oh, I got the cheap stuff. That's probably a wise idea. Seeing as I believe tonight... Quantity rather than quality is going to be the essence or the requirement. Right. So. I'm going to kill the music. Do we need it? Does it tell us anything about the mood? Probably tells us about the mood. Okay. My lips have gone numb. That really did hit the skin. So, why the hell was the theme music for this game Long live the Queen. Why? Well, not long live the Queen, sorry. God save the Queen, excuse me. The British national anthem. Skills. The skills she learns will provide different choices in the ongoing plot. There's a plot, ladies and gentlemen. Learning the right skills can mean the difference between life and death. Straw poll time. Who's hoping for death? Never mind, I can already see the results of that straw poll. Mood. Not good. You also need to keep an eye on Elodie's mood. With her mother's tragic death, Elodie is not very happy right now. Excellent. I like her already, apart from the whole mutant thing. The mood button will take you to the emotions screen for more details. Okay, Elodie is feeling both afraid and depressed, but her strongest emotion is depressed. If she becomes more cheerful to cancel out the depression, her strongest emotion would then be afraid. Okay. But this affects her ability to learn. It will give her bonus to some skills and penalties to others. Let's take a look at the skill screen now. Ooh, yes, let's. Holy crap, it's an RPG. Skills are broken into four main categories. Social, physical, intellectual, and mystical. I get magic. Inside these categories are skill sets, groups of three related skills. You start with zero in all skills. Every week, Elodie can study two skills. Normally, she earns 2 points a skill for every weekday that she studies. So if she studies history, she will earn 2 points times 5 days, 10 points. Thank you for the basic maths class. Because Elodie is depressed, she has a -2 penalty to the social skill set, conversation. She doesn't feel like talking to people right now. Again, Elodie is it Elodie or Elodie? Well, whichever it is, she's making perfect sense to me. If she studies conversation, she will earn 2 -2 points per day. That is 0 points. Again, thank you for that. 2 take away 2 is 0. I was wrong. This is a little too basic for my 7-year-old. However, she has +1 bonus to the expression skill set. If she studies the expression skills, she will earn 2 + 1 points per day, which means 3 points per day. So because she's depressed, she can actually earn expression points. Would those expressions be rage? If you study a skill you have a penalty for, you could be wasting your time. Yes, that would probably be the theme for tonight. And not learning anything. If you study a skill you have bonuses for, you will learn much faster than normal. ...344 people watching me do this. All of the bonuses and penalties will change when Elodie's mood changes. She can also gain bonuses to skills by studying related skills. Check the skills screen every week to see your current bonuses. Awesome. Once you know your mood, skills, bonuses and penalties, you are ready to choose your classes for the week. The classes screen breaks down the skill sets by category for your morning and evening classes. When you select a skill set, the three options in that set will appear on the right side of the screen. Gopher, for the love of God, mute the music. Oh, I don't need to. I took my headphones off. So, I'm fine. Don't worry about it. Choose a class option for both morning and evening classes, then click the... Okay, Sunlit Karma, resub. Thank you for scaring everyone half to death. Cheers. So. Choose a class option for both morning and evening classes, then click the done button. Yes, the alcohol is definitely taking effect on my lips. It will appear in the lower right corner. As you play through the story, you will sometimes see feedback bubbles appearing over the text. These tell you what's happening behind the scenes. Bubbles like this will show you when Elodie's mood is being altered by events. Oh god, seriously, can we fix her bedroom? Shit. It's horrible. Bubbles like these will show you where the story is changing based on what skills. Oh god, the feedback is very helpful. No one cares. Now get ready to become queen. Excellent! Who can we execute first? What was mood? Oh no, do we have to keep outfit? We're still in the tutorial, aren't we? Boarding school uniform. Brilliant. Classes. Log. So if I look at my mood, I'm willful. No, I'm not. I'm average there. I'm a little afraid and I'm a little depressed. My classes allows you to select military classes. What? Say no, no, not save. I didn't. What? I didn't. I clicked here. Oh, military allows you to select military classes. So we're on it. But I'm a cute. No, let's go back to skills. Skills! Mystical, intellectual, social, and physical. She's got a bonus at the moment for expression, which is decoration, instrument, and voice. We could practice our voice. Dance, reflexes, flexibility, swords, archery, pole arms. Well, I'm the queen. Why would I want to swords and archery? I'm the bloody queen. I point at people and say, shoot them. Athletics, no. Animal handling, horse, dogs, falcons. No dragons. Intellectual. Blah, blah, blah. Am I good at anything intellectual? Just military has got a zero bonus at the moment. Faith. Blah, blah. Lumen. Sense. Magic. Mystical and military. Okay. Moon Songstress. Really? People are subscribing because I'm playing this game? You are going to be very, 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 very disappointed. You need reflexes. What do I need reflexes for? I make it. Ooh, we're gonna get assassination. Make the music stop. Nope. So, I need reflexes. Why? Why? I need dog handling. Because a good leader's in the front lines with his army rather than the back. I'm a four-year-old girl! What sort of four-year-old girl is a good leader by being in the front of the army? What do they do? Stick me on a bloody pole and use me as a mascot? Makes sense. Do-do-do. No, we're going for strategy. I like strategy. Wield magic. Ooh, could I become an evil sorceress? Could I destroy the world? I like the sound of that. Well, I'm good at voice. So I think we're going for voice. Or is that singing? Because if that's singing, I'm going to beat somebody up. And I like military strategy. Logistics. Logistics is surprisingly underrated. Okay, let's... Classes. This week we will go for expression classes. And we will go for military. Yes, we will. Now what? So that's it. That's just it. I go, done. Week one. You need to pick both a morning and an evening class. I did. Military. Expression. Oh. No, okay. Have I not done... Why does right-click go over save game? What possesses you to think I want to save this game? Morning class. Oh, class options. Okay, expression. Voice. Got it. Yes, military. Strategy. Got it. Bonus. Depressed. Excellent. I'm going to keep you depressed. You practice deep breathing exercises to build up your ability to sustain a note. It's singing. It didn't want singing. Are you... didn't want singing. I wanted commanding voice. Jesus. We're waiting. Do I click something again? Okay. Okay, you study the strengths and weaknesses of different weapons in battle formations. What's all that noise outside? Who's here? My eyeballs are getting bigger, but also moving more into position. Is this something about growing up? Week by week, my eyeballs go to a more natural position? Do they shrink? Do I become like a normal human eventually? Oh, okay, no, apparently not. Oh, it's my cousins, my aunt and uncle. Darling, she's slightly more normal. We were so terribly sorry to hear about your mother, Fidelia. Thank you. My eyes are back. You look well, niece. Dude, shave it off. Nobody's impressed. Whoa! With the eyeballs there. Charlotta, Lady Merva. Hi, Lottie. Hi, Lottie. Haven't seen you in ages. Will you be staying long? Please say no, because I hate you all, and I'm going to poison you all in your sleep. Yup, Mummy said we're to be here all month. Would you like to take bets on that? Maybe we'll have some time to talk later. Apparently I'm cheerful, which is going to make my training in the art of voice difficult. Don't cheer me up. Okay, now that you've finished studying, what will you do for the weekend? Visit the dungeons. No effect, really? Visit Charlotta? Question mark. Play with toys! Yielding, lonely, and cheerful. Sneak out! Willful and lonely. I like the idea of that. Let's go. Should we become totally willful and totally lonely? Lonely and cheerful. Talk to your father. Attend court. Plus one depressed. Does that mean I actually get more depressed? I get like more miserable. I like the idea of that. Lonely and afraid. I'm thinking sneak out. I mean, Charlotte, yeah, we don't want to. Visit tomb. Plus one depressed. Plus one afraid. Attend service. Minus one depressed. Surely just cheerful counters depressed, doesn't it? Or is depressed a completely different thing to cheerful? Sneak out. We're going out. You sneak out of the castle to have a little fun. You enjoy your freedom, but your father won't like it if he finds out. We don't care. We don't like father. Okay. Skills. Royal demeanor, minus one. Conversation, minus two. Expression. Ooh, look at that. Should we max out the voice? Should we just become completely... Oh, we're getting better at the military thing as well. Look at that. 0.1. Animal handling's getting better. Okay. Mood. Where we are? So, no. Right. We're definitely heading towards... Oh, willful. Willful. Pressured. Lonely. I like willful. Willful, angry. Okay, we want to cure afraid, so we become angry and willful. Angry and willful. Intrigue? Ciphering. Foreign intelligence. Oh, I like the idea of this. I am liking the idea of this. Let's go back to the skills. Let's have a look. Composure. Physical. Foreign affairs. Internal affairs. Foreign intelligence. No, you know what? Military strategy. We're going to crush the world. Yes, we are. Week 2, morning. You study the effects of battle stress on troops and how morale can turn the tide of combat. Military recruitment and the importance of training and motivation in making soldiers who can trust and depend on each other. Yes, indeed. Okay, what's the commotion outside? Father, what's going on? Juliana, Duchess of Ursel. I've come to pay my respects in honor of your mother. Jocelyn, King... Okay, blah, blah. You have no respect or honor. It's because of you and your powers that my wife is dead. She has powers? What? Question mark, exclamation mark, question mark. Because apparently I exclaim in triplicate. I am a lumen, as was she. And like every lumen, I am willing to give my life, if necessary, to protect... Our domain. What the hell's a lumen? Your line has been traitors for 200 years. I won't have you corrupting my daughter. That is for the Crown Princess to decide. Eladar, your mother trusted me, and I have much to teach you. Excellent. Send her away. Let her stay. Arrest her. Let her stay. I want to hear what she has to say. She stay. Ooh, now he's... Yes. As you wish. I do. Now that you've finished studying, what will you do for the weekend? Yielding. Now, what was it we wanted to do? Angry. We away from... Afraid. We don't want to be afraid. Not afraid. Definitely not afraid. Visit Charlotta Lady... No. The Duchess Ursel. Visit... That was her, right? That was her. What is it you wanted to teach me? First, I need to know if you have your mother's crystal. I don't know. There we go. Law failed. What? The source of power for any lumen is a particular magical crystal. Once you've bonded with it, it becomes part of you as long as you live. The royal crystal has been passed down from ruler to ruler for generations. It belongs to you now, except that the king may be keeping it from you. Ooh. Do you have a crystal? Of course. She holds out her hands, light flickers above her bosom. And then, with a shower of sparkles, something takes shape. Stab her in the face and steal hers. You reach out to touch it, and it dissolves away into nothing. Oh, it belongs to me. No one can take it from me until I die. You need to find the crystal that belongs to you. I may have already done that. Oh, okay, right. What have we got? Mood-wise. Still willful. Snee. Okay. Glasses. Is it faith? Finding a main... Lumen. Sense magic. Resist magic. Wield magic. And strategy. Not strategy. Military strategy, yes. Okay. Okay then. Right, so we're gonna go for... Wait, what? Mystical. Classes, mystical. Come on, where's mystical? Entry medicine. Where's mystical? Where's bloody mystical? I'm not seeing mystical. Meditation, perhaps? Is it under faith? No, that sounds wrong. Faith, meditation, divination, and lore. I'm looking for lumen. Why don't I have lumen? Oh, I don't have my crystal yet. Got it. Fine. Voice expression. Military. Strategy. Let's keep going until we've filled whatever that yellow bar does, so we become a... Yes, we sing. La 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 la. And I become a military genius. You may now take a tour of the barracks on the weekends. Oh, so as I gain skill... Oh, is if I max out the yellow, does that become the maximum for... Oh, right, okay. I thought that you get the yellow and then you become... Charlotta, Lady Merva, he loves me not. Not. Lottie, do you have a boyfriend? Not really, I just like to play with the flowers. All of a sudden, the Duchess of Ursel rushes in the garden and points a sword at you. No, not at you, at your feet. Princess, don't move. Hold still. We're going to trust her because she's going to teach us to kill. You want to hold still, but you don't have the composure to hold your position without peeking. No! You look down to where the sword is pointing. There's a snake in the grass. You can't help it. You squeak and jump back, plus one afraid. The snake tenses and prepares to snipe. Charlotta, Lady Merva, no! Your cousin pushes you aside and the snake fangs sink into her leg. Lottie! Too late. Juliana swings her sword and cuts off the snake's head. Countess of Nyx, what is going on out here? Your daughter's been bitten by a milk viper. They're poisonous. Get a herbalist right away. I will treat my daughter. I certainly can't trust anyone here to keep her safe. Would somebody kill the pianist, please? Thank you. I don't feel good. Now you're going to die. I will return home to Merva immediately. Bye-bye. Your aunt has a point. Milk vipers are not native to this area. That snake should never have been around here. Yeah, of course, it was an assassination plot. Oh, for seriously, with the piano. Someone may have tried to kill you. Do you think? Will Charlotte be okay? Don't care. I don't know. Right. Please. I can visit the barracks. Minus one willful. Plus one pressured. Should we go talk to Papa? Dad, what happened to Mum's lumen crystal? Give it to me. It's in a safe place. Can I have it? No. But it's mine. And I want it. Meddling with magic killed your mother. I don't want that to happen to you. Oh, boo-hoo. Once you're crowned queen, I can't stop you from doing anything you want, but for now, you're still a child. Go steal the crystal. Is she looking a bit kind of evil now? She's looking a little... the willful thing, isn't it? I need to get angry. I don't mind lonely. So what was that whole thing? You don't have the discipline. Is that, like, composure? Yeah, but I can't be I don't have composure. Composure just is not me, so get over it. Intrigue. Internal affairs. Foreign intelligence. Ciphering. I like it. I like it. Intrigue. Internal affairs. History. No. Military. Strategy. Still. We're going to become a military strategist. Until you have children of your own, your maternal uncle, the Duke of Merva, is next in line for the crown, and after him would be his daughter, your cousin Charlotta. Okay. You study the effects of different kinds of battle terrain for both offense and defense. Your skill in strategy is now 50. You may not increase this skill until your other military skills are 25 or higher. Okay. The castle seems quieter with Charlotta and Emery and Zara. Who the hell's Zara? And their parents gone. It's certainly not empty, though. It seems like we get more servants every day. I was so worried about Charlotta after that snake bit her. But her mother said she's okay, so I guess it turned out all right. Maybe she has a guardian angel. If so, could you ask her to bring back my eyeballs, which seem to have gone on vacation once more? What will you do now you've finished studying? Yielding. No, yielding is like the opposite of willful, isn't it? We don't want that. Lonely, that could be kind of... Plus one lonely and plus one cheerful. Because depressed, I quite fancy being angry and cheerful. Plus one lonely, no, we don't want to be afraid. Plus two yielding. Plus one depressed. Plus one... Visit the dungeons. Well, that gives me plus one willful. I don't need plus one willful yet. No, I don't. That removes my willfulness, but it increases my depressed and pressured. All right. And that, okay. Lonely and cheerful, and also yielding. Let's go to the gardens. A walk in the fresh air helps you forget the burdens on your shoulders. Okay, let's have a look at my mood. See, I'm a little less afraid now. A little less depressed. A bit more lonely. Hello! Resub, Kizzy Kais 15. Okay, so... skills, what have we got? Right, now, for the strategy ones, I need to increase the others to 25, otherwise I can't increase my strategy. It seems that what you have to do is increase all of them along. Voice seems to be just singing. It really does seem to be completely and utterly singing. Conversation, public speaking, court manners, flattery. Interesting. Divination. Intrigue. Logistics. There we go. Military logistics and intrigue. Internal affairs. Let's... Foreign intelligence. No, let's... Yeah, we'll do that. Learn how to defend yourself. I have people for defending myself. Shut up. The current Duke of Sedna is 26 years old and unmarried. He might be considered a good marriage prospect for you if you desire stronger ties in the domain of Talassi. You learn about the types and amounts of food required for an army on the march and how long they will remain edible. One of the maids approaches for your attention. My lady, couriers have arrived from the Duke of Sedna. Sedna, that's in Talassi, the domain to our southeast. I know this because I have learned about it. They have brought you a letter and a gift. It's probably a trap. Condolences on the death of, deeply regret, best wishes. Oh, what a beautiful necklace. Something sparkly will make me feel better. Court manners failed, plus one cheerful. Brilliant. I don't have court manners. Now that you've finished studying, what will you do? Should we go and see her again and say, look, seriously, that she's not... Yeah, let's do that. My father says I can't have the crystal until I'm queen, so we'll just have to wait. There may not be time to wait. This world is filled with dangers and you will need the powers of Lumen to fight them. You can't begin training until you've bonded with your crystal. What else am I supposed to do about it? The crystal is probably held under guard in the royal treasury. You are the princess. You should be able to find a way inside. Okay. Otherwise, we might have to take drastic action. What drastic action? What do you mean by drastic action? Let's hope it doesn't come to that. No, let's just jump to drastic. I'm okay with drastic. Drastic sounds fun. Try to reach the crystal. If you can't, come and talk to me again. Of course I won't be able to. Fine. Mood. Still willful. A little bit more cheerful, though. Still not angry. Skills. My history's kind of sucking. Is this because I'm willful now? It's probably because I'm willful, isn't it? Royal demeanor. Okay. Naval strategy, perhaps. Let's become ciphering. Okay. Glasses. Ciphering and naval strategy. Fun, even if it means killing daddy, especially if it means killing daddy. You practice reading words whose letters have been arranged in reverse order, the simplest transpositions which anyone literate can puzzle through if they try, but sometimes useful to hide information. Thug is near Lipni. Okay, don't care. Bonus to willful. Oh no, we get a bonus because of willful. You learn that the sea is not something you hold, it is something you travel across. Naval strategy ensures your free travel while denying it to your enemies. Excellent. Okay. As you're walking, you spot a familiar figure in the palace gardens. It's the Duchess of Ursel. Maybe I should go and say hello. Then you notice that seated beside her is a woman in the robes of a priestess. They are very close together, their hands gently touching as they speak. Looks like she's busy. Smirk, smirk. You turn around and walk in a different direction so as not to disturb them. At that moment, you notice something unusual. It looks like someone just left the palace grounds by going over the hedge. Was that a servant, a thief, or an assassin? Climb and look up hedge. Yes! You look around for something to climb. I can't climb. You run over to a statue and try and pull yourself up above the pedestal, but it's too awkward and you get your feet in place. By this time, whoever you saw has probably gone away. I should have called for the guards. Of course I should. Okay, we're going to go to the dungeons and get... Oh, no, we're not. We're going to the treasury. You try to... Okay, angry and willful. I got angry and willful. But I failed something and it went past too fast. They won't budge. Mood. A little bit angrier. Already about as willful as you could possibly be. Glasses. Oh, actually skills. So, I need climbing. Or was it agility? Something like that. Climbing. I need climbing to be able to climb trees. Good God. I need things like court manners and public speaking, don't I? Court manners. I think I need court manners as well as, you know, naval strategy and logistics. Okay, let's go for court manners. And logistics again. You review the correct greetings for guests according to rank, and when to extend your hand to another. All nobles expect their due honours. You study the kinds of equipment that soldiers need available, such as bedding, weapons, armour and medicine and bandages, and the tools to repair anything damaged. You study different kinds of transport, animals, wagons, sledges, ships, boats and boots. Okay. As you are walking up the stairs, a maid comes running down holding a towering pile of linen. Before you can react, she... reflexes failed. Elegance failed. Okay. Oh, my lady, I'm so sorry. You're going to be executed. No, you're not. That's fine. No, that's... Court manners failed. No, it's... Don't worry about it. I should have gotten out of your way. That makes me depressed. Apparently, if you say so, my lady. I do. I'm the queen. Okay, Ooh! I can't go talk to... I can't... Okay. Cherub IMX, resub. Welcome. That gets us angry. The plus one willful and... Do we have a chance now? Let's go back again. Accounting failed, presence failed. It's presence, but I'm getting angrier. I'm getting angrier. Okay, so, I like that. It's presence, that's what I needed. Presence. Oh no, I suck at presence. Presence, what was the other one? Elegance or something like that? No, flattery? I don't know. I suck at it. I need to get my, okay, something just beeped on me. Royal demeanor. Doesn't tell me what. Yeah, no, God, no. Conversation, courtly manners, public speaking, flattery. Accounting was the other one, was it? Accounting! Can I get a... Economics! I'm crap at accounting as well. Current mood, willful. Bonus to intrigue, military. Penalty to royal demeanor, history and economics. Maybe I start reducing my willful nature a little bit, just so I can increase these. Okay, fine. Well, until I do that, let's go for the things that I actually have bonuses for, which currently are intrigue and military strategist. Let's go to classes. Naval strategy and intrigue, internal affairs. Okay, we got to reduce willful, though. Your maternal uncle's wife, the Countess Nix, claims kinship with the old Merva line and originally asked your mother for title to the duchy. However, no one could verify her lineage. As a compromise, your mother created her brother, Duke of Merva. The last Duke of Mead was the older half-brother of the current Duchess. His reign was brief and highly scandalous. He defied tradition to pledge himself as a life mate of the old Duke of Ursel, then broke that off only a year later. He retired into seclusion and died, still unwed. You study different kinds of ships, their names, designs, and number of crew needed for each. You study different kinds of ships, their speed, maneuverability, standard... Okay, yeah, brilliant. You've unlocked a new outfit. Really? Excellent. Is it pirate? There is a man here to see you. He wishes crown funding for a project of his. Remember, the treasury is not unlimited. If you choose to invest, you will have less money to work with later. Your Royal Highness, I have a plan to print books using metal letters which can be moved and reused. I need to borrow 875 lassi to assemble the metal and factory to mold and cast the type. With this system, we'll be able to create new books in a fraction of the time it takes now and make copies to send all over the world. I don't know much about factories or trade. Would that really be worthwhile? We are not interested. Why aren't we interested? Oh, I was interested. Okay. That reduces willfulness. I think so does that. Alright, let's just play with some toys, have some fun. Spend a weekend holed up alone in your room with a favourite toys. It's childish, but you feel a bit better. Do I get better bonuses on my skills now? Not really. Still much better at intrigue and strategy. All that. Okay, right, we can now go for military strategy. We can now go for military. I've got a new outfit. What's my new outfit? Uniform! Yes! Yes! Definitely. Classes. Intrigue. Foreign intelligence. And strategy. The domain Shangjia across the sea to the west has been steadily increasing in size and now controls a wide range of coastline as well as most of the navigable rivers. The political disruption in Tumbala in recent years has caused a disruption in their chocolate production, which is to the benefit of Nova, particularly the Duchy of Kigal. Afternoon. You study the power of ranged weapons, from arrows to thrown fire and sand, and how the threat of such attacks can shift the enemy's response. You study the use of cavalry in battle, as well as the costs and benefits of travelling with large animals. Banyan, Duke of Marie, Earl of Serendipitam. Your Highness, my sympathies for your loss. Even after all those years, I sometimes forget that my own mother will never be coming back. Thank you. However, I must call for your aid. The Ixionite occupation of the country of Imbrium has gone on for too long. Now is the time to push back. Foreign affairs failed, really? I know there's been some problems with Ixion, but I don't know the details. I guess they're occupying Southern Marie. We have plenty of troops, so it shouldn't be that hard to drive them out if we want to make a fight of it. Ooh, I succeeded. Prepare for battle! Forget negotiations, I'm better at battle. Well, if they want to fight, then we'll give it to them. I will arrange for troops to be sent to your aid. Thank you, Your Highness. Plus one willful. I didn't want to be willful. I didn't want to be willful. I did not. I'm trying to work on that. Your Highness, if I may ask, that necklace you're wearing, where did it come from? It was a gift from the Duke of Sedna. Then you have made arrangements with him? I think he's asking if I'm engaged to the Duke. No, I'm not. No, I just like jewellery. Not at all. Plus one willful. Okay, seriously, with the willful, I'm trying to get rid of the willfulness. But I appreciate presents. Doesn't everybody? If you say so, Your Highness. Right. Plus yielding, plus one depressed. So all of that yielding I developed, all of that yielding, completely and utterly wasted. Okay, minus one willful and plus one pressured, maybe? You're impressed by the discipline of the Novan troops, but the responsibility for their lives weighs heavily on your shoulders. There are approximately 10 battalions under your direct command. Mood. Still ridiculously willful. Still insanely willful. Completely and utterly willful. I need to get cheerful. I do need to get cheerful. Desperately, actually. Maybe pressured as well. Pressured and cheerful. Pressured and cheerful. We're going for pressured and cheerful skills. Right. Court manners. Internal affairs. I think we go for ciphering. And I don't know, I'm sort of semi-tempted to keep going on the strategy. Become like literally a military strategist of epic, epic proportions. There's only one other person streaming this game. Oh, well, there's a surprise, there's an absolute shock. God, there are 465 people watching me do this. That I don't believe. But there you go. Right, so, I've got a star next to the military. Does that mean I'm really good at military already? I should probably just ignore it a little bit. Let's go for intrigue. And I want to carry on with court manners. Conversation. Court manners. And intrigue. Foreign intelligence. As a person of highest rank within the domain, no one may sit at any formal event unless you give them permission. Haha, excellent. And no one must ever turn their back on you. If they do, they are intended to recognize the insult. Afternoon. Since their recent revolution, the Trombolans have twice begun gathering troops on the Novan border. Both times their camps were struck by fierce storms and earthquakes, and they decided to give up on the idea. Pirates are once again operating out of Orcus, although they are currently sticking to the northern seas and no threat to Nova. However, if they turn the slave raids, the Borealans may be quite vulnerable. Your skill in foreign intelligence is now 50. You may not increase it until your other intrigue skills are 25 or higher. Okay, brilliant. Yeah, yeah. You receive a report on the outcome of the battle against Ixionites. Zelfos, I will get you something cool soon. Just don't kill me yet. I will strawpole it. You succeeded in driving them out of Marie, but it cost you over half a battalion of soldiers and a great deal of material. You lost 634 soldiers. Really? The Duke of Marie will be happy, but we could have done better. Plus one angry. I like it. Not the losing, but the... Okay. Talk to your father. Perhaps we should. We want pressured, actually. We're looking for pressured. We're looking for pressured. So that would actually be good. Touring the barracks is a good one. But I say we talk to father. Dad, if this trouble with Ixion started years ago, why didn't Mom fix it? Your mother told the Duke of Marie to the Duchess of Hellas that it was their problem and they should sort it out themselves. Why isn't he the king? Am I living in a matriarchal society so that only women can rule? Oh. Should I have done that? The situation is different now. Everyone on all sides wishes to see what sort of queen is coming to the throne. One that will straddle the world and conquer her enemies. Everyone is judging me. Plus one yielding and plus one pressured. I like it. I like it. That was good. That was good. Mood. A little less willful. Bit more pressured. Bit angry. Getting balanced now. Bit more balance going on here. Let's have a look at the skills. Ciphering. We need to get ciphering up so that we can increase internal affairs and foreign intelligence to the higher level. So we're going to put ciphering up and court manners. I still want court manners. Yes, I do. Classes. Court manners, and this time ciphering. Yes. You study rules for formal dining, including the proper utensils for different dishes. As the queen, no one will comment on your mistakes, but they will notice them. Afternoon. You practice shifting substitution ciphers, where each letter is replaced by one of a few steps further along the alphabet, so that cake and pie becomes... You practice random blah blah blah. Okay, this is harder to decode, but most people need a written substitution chart to read or write it, and that chart can be lost or stolen. You have unlocked a new outfit. What's my new outfit? Okay. Oh. There are reports that a key thong has been sighted leaving the old forest. What the hell is that? Thank you. What's a key thong? Novan history failed. All right. A beast with the body of an enormous golden cat, a sharp beak and spikes on its back. It's a bloody Gruffalo. Eek. Eek? Really eek? Several disappearances in southern Caloris are already thought to be the work of this creature. What do we do? Should we send hunters? The traditional policy on stray beasts is to hope that they return to the forest and stay there. Hunters are no match for such creatures. You would only make it angry and waste more lives. So we just let it eat people. Everyone dies in the end. It's a little fatalistic, isn't it? Plus one depressed. Also, there's a letter for you. Thanks. Talaris, the Duke of Sedna, will be arriving next week for an official visit. Okay. What was it? I was willful and pressured. No, we want cheerful. We want pressured, but we want cheerful. So we're looking for pressured, not lonely. Okay, just... Sitting in on court sessions is not fun at all, but it pleases your father and it may be important for your future. I seem to get... Okay, I'm looking a bit miserable now, aren't I? What happened to my mood? I became less cheerful, but I'm now on the whole middling here. A little less willful. Can we get the angry? Skills. It's beginning to balance out on the intrigue thing, but I'm hoping to get more... Is it... No. Accounting. Right, accounting's no longer got a minus. So I'm thinking... Court manners we leave where it is for now, and we go for accounting. Because presence is just about it. Accounting. And internal affairs. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. History. Economics. Accounting. And internal affairs. Oh, I forgot to check my bloody outfit. You brush up on the basic mathematics with the help of an abacus. Brilliant. The Duke of Marie has paid suit to the Duchess of Ursel to no avail. The Duchess's brother is opposed as he will inherit if he dies childless. Your agents suspect that the Duchess of Ursel has actually more interested in the Duchess of Hellas. Neither has ever been linked to a man. Okay. Countess Leek of Dis married the old Duke of Sudbury, who was more than twice her age, then divorced him as soon as she bore him an heir in order to marry another. It was considered shockingly rude by the general nobility, but the old Duke apparently had no objection. Gay. Ah, oh, Your Highness, this is Duke of Sedna. What a pleasure it is to meet you in person at last. Your description did not do you justice. Obviously didn't describe how swollen my eyeballs were. Giggle. I don't know how to deal with handsome older men paying me compliments. I was so pleased to hear you had accepted my humble offering, a jewel for a jewel, but you are more precious. I hope this is only the beginning of a mutually beneficial relationship. A union between us would bring stability for both our peoples. He really does want to marry me. No, so, well, go away. I barely know you, and I'm like 6 years old, and you're at least 9. I need to let him down gently. Court manners failed. I'm not marrying you. I'm only 14. 14? I'm never 14. That may not have been gentle, do you think? I see. I regret the misunderstanding. Good. Do you feel depressed and pressured? Right, I don't want to be depressed, but... How can I get cheerful, pressured, and yielding? Line. Sitting in court sessions is not fun at all, but it pleases your father. Blah. Right, let's have a look at my outfits. I've got a new one, which is... Ooh, I can boost intrigue. Are you kidding me? You're really kidding me. You're kidding me. You are. You're kidding me. Right, let's have a look at this. Skills. I get a boost to intrigue. Oh, that's what the star was. I get a boost to them. So I can now get more intrigue skills if I want them. Well, I'm not training up on... Okay. What was it I was... Right, accounting. Accounting and... Court manners, but... Court manners is getting up to that sort of limit now. Imagine, minus 1.68, what? Okay, court manners, not gonna happen. What, I need to be happy, don't I? I need to be happy, god damn it. I need to be happy, god, I gotta get happy. It's kind of annoying. Maybe I should put some thinking into... Nah, okay. It will do... Foreign intelligence and accounting. Yes. Okay, you study the manipulation of larger quantities through direct calculations using written numbers instead of an abacus. Agents who have visited Borealis report that all known Lumen shamans seem to have no magical powers at all and perform their ritual displays with show and trickery. Interesting. You are requested to stand in judgment. A woman has been convicted of attempted murder and requests the mercy of the crown. Your Highness, this slattern dares to beg pardon when she admits that she tried to poison my sister under her own roof. Which sister? Corisande, the Duchess of Mead. Is she all right? She is unharmed. We caught the culprit in the kitchens before anyone could eat her foul spew. Well, what do you have to say for yourself? It's justice, it is. Them devils killed me brother and broke me mam's heart. Lied to her, they did, when she went to see why he'd not come back. Said he'd gone for a soldier when he never would. He weren't the only one, neither. I waited 10 years for my chance to get my own back. That's justice. You see, she's completely unrepentant. Hang her and be done with it. Partial success. This might have something to do with the last Duke of Mead. He was involved in all sorts of scandals. Ask the Earl of Low about her story. I need to know if she has any justification for her actions. Did the old Duke kill her brother? Are you accusing my family? Yes! Would you like to go to war? Because I'm okay with that. I'm asking what happened. Angry face. The honour of our line is far greater than that of a wet-bottomed child who sits on the throne. Destroy the Earl of Io. What? Without warning, the Earl of Io draws a dagger and slices the convict's throat. No one harms my family. No one. He throws the bloodied, stained blade to the floor and walks away. Ooh. Really, ooh. Visit the treasury. You tried to talk. Accounting failed. Presence failed. Angry and willful. I don't want to be willful. You tried to walk past, but it's... Pressured. I need to be cheerful. I need to be bloody cheerful so I can get better at the cheerful stuff. God damn it. Fine. So I'm not very good at the history is one of the big problems here. I'm sort of good at the intrigue, but not the history. Fine. We're going to go for a bit more military because we're going to go and find Io and kill them all. And we still need to do some accounting. We need to increase accounting. I want to do the history as well. God damn it. Accounting and military logistics. You study money lending and the controversies involved in charging interest. According to the Druids, one should always return more than one is loaned, or else the debt gave no value to the world. Afternoon. You learn about the supported costs created by support, and the more equipment you have, the more people and animals are needed to move them, and then those people and animals also need to be fed and equipped. You learn about the difficulty of obtaining new supplies from the field. Enemy civilians may hide or destroy supplies rather than let them fall into your hands, and friendly civilians may not stay friendly if robbed. As you are walking one day in the gardens, you hear a strange sound and look up to see an owl flying overhead. A single dry leaf flutters in its talons. Divination failed. Falcons failed. That's funny. I thought owls were nocturnal, I guess. I was wrong. When you return to the castle, your father is waiting for you. There's a woman here to see you. She wishes crown funding for a project. Thank you for me, Your Royal Highness. I come to you on behalf of the people. I wish to build a hospital where any citizen afflicted with a disease can be brought for treatment. Battlefield medicine and herbs failed. Putting all the sick together people, wouldn't that make them die even faster? We're not interested. God damn it, I'm such a brainless fart. Okay, I need to be cheerful. I do need to be cheerful, and apparently my cheerfulness is all around. I don't want to be lonely, though. This is... You spend the weekend holed up, playing with toys. Mood. I'm heading towards yielding, though. Let's see what that does. I'm angry, but yielding. Angry, but yielding. What does that give me in bonus-wise? Conversation! Little better off. As is accounting. I'm thinking we train up accounting and... court manners. I mean, I do want to keep boosting those as well. Oh, mind you, I want naval strategy as well. I really want to become good at war. Okay, let's go for accounting. Let's stick with what we've been doing, accounting and naval strategy. I just want to be ready to go to war because I plan on doing so. You study bookkeeping and the art of notating incomes and expenditures, as well as how to determine the amount of funds a solvent business needs to keep on hand in order to continue functioning. Okay, bonus. I get a bonus for being angry. Okay. So being angry helps me with the military. Excellent. Remember that the Festival of the Good Lady is approaching. There will be a public celebration of the commoners, followed by a grand gala for the nobility. A grand ball. There will be dancing, she says. But will there be fighting? As queen, you would be expected to lead the procession and take part in the ceremonial planting. Possibly give a speech. However, since you are not yet crowned, it is not required, and it may not be safe to expose you to the public. What do you mean, not safe? Outside of the castle, you are less well protected. If anyone means you harm, think on it now. Decide later. There is a letter for you as well. It's from Bryony. I went to school with her, but she's a total dweeb. She was a couple of years older than me. Her mother is the Duchess of Mead. All right, it's close to dweeb. She's complaining that her mother still won't let her come home for the holidays. Apparently her uncle Kevin is absolutely furious about that woman's trial. Don't be blaming me. She's bored and looking for an adventure. Well, I don't have any to suggest to her. Eeky. Do you think I can get there now? Because that always makes me angry, doesn't it? Always makes me seriously, seriously angry. Why don't I actually have anything that makes me happy except this one? Or that one, but... Am I ready for the treasury yet, do you think? Partial success, plus one angry, plus one willful. You try to explain to the guards that you need to visit the treasury in order to get an accurate report on the domain's finances. They waver slightly, but in the end, they stand by your father's commands. Oh, for mood. Getting angrier. Also getting depressed again. A little bit... Oh, but we're completely balanced there. All right. Still need more bloody accounting. But I can't. Okay. Relax. Court manners. Court manners and production. Court manners and production. Yes, indeed. Court manners and production. Start accounting, learn weapons. What, you want me to kill the guards to get in to get that jewel? Really? You want me to go stab my father's guards? That sounds clever. Okay. Brilliant. Fishing. Today is a procession and planting of the Festival of the Good Lady. Will you be leading the parade? If you have any concerns about safety, please stay here. The people will recover from disappointment. If we lose you, there is no recovery. I will parade and make a speech. I will not make a speech. I will lead the parade. I'm not really good at that sort of thing. I'm not. No, I'd rather not go. Nope, guess I'd rather stay here. You watch the procession. Plus one, yielding and lonely. Feeling safe but lonely. Suddenly you hear someone moving around inside your room. You turn in surprise, but it's only a maid. Milady, what are you? Should you not be in the procession? Faith failed. Skipping the major festival. Is everyone wondering about me? Confess your fears. Yell at her. That would make me angry. This would make me yielding. I kind of want both. Yielding is something I kind of need to work on. Yell at would make me angry. I'm already about as angry as I need to be. I can't go outside. Plus one afraid. No, that's the opposite of angry. There might be assassins. Oh. That's not quite what I want to do. I need to get my other accounting skills to over 25 so I can boost that. Plus two yielding, plus one depressed, plus one pressured. Plus two, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, yeah. Let's have a look. Skills. Mood. We're now pretty angry again, but we're also getting depressed. I want to be cheerful. It's so bloody hard to be cheerful other than playing with lily pads and toys. losing my willful edge as well. Really losing it now. Losing it big time. This is not good. Fine. Trade and production. We need trade and production. Court manners are now maxed out, I think. Public speak. Oh, and I've got a big minus on these anyway, so forget it. That's not going. That's not happening. Horses, dogs, falcons. No, don't care. Intrigue. I should do some history. I should do some history, but trade and production. Trade and production classes. Okay. I've got to get both of those to 25 so I can boost the other one. Are you ready for the grand ball? No, I hate balls. All the nobles in the domain are here to see you, to see their queen. Gulp. You finish dressing and descend the stairs to make a grand entrance. Okay. All around, the rich and powerful pause in their activities to gaze upon you, the ruler of them all. Seeing yourself for a After a moment, you force yourself to carry on, but you're sure they all see you hesitate. Your father awaits for you at the bottom of the stairs and offers you his arm. The first dance is for us. He guides you gently around the dance floor, never rushing you. It's fun to dance with your father, but the look in his eyes is so sad. After this, you must choose your own partner. There are a number of men who hope to catch your eye. The Duke of Kigal alone has brought three eligible sons, all near your age. You look around the room. Fearwolf. Welcome, Fearwolf. No one may begin dancing until you do. You can pick whomever you want, and you will not be denied. Success! No doubt every noble family with eligible sons has dreams of a loyal wedding. Royal wedding? Your choice will raise some hopes and dash others. Feuds could be born here. The Duke of Kigal has not yet named any of his sons the official heir, but his second son, Linley, is always kind to you at school. If you wish to show favour to Kigal, Linley would be your choice. The Duke of Elorath is currently held in regency in its Lord Adard, who is only 12 and a head shorter than you are. Elorath is rich territory, and at least a little Adair wouldn't try to take any liberties. Banyan, the Duke of Marie, would be quite awkward if you did not actually wish to marry him. He's been waiting years for a powerful heiress to accept his suit. Not all nobles are created equal. You could choose someone charming and unimportant like Earl of Mimma, a territory too minor for anyone to consider it a threat. However, the families might eat him alive afterwards. If you'd wish to distract attention from your marital prospects, you could choose someone clearly ineligible. One of your uncles, or an older family man like the Earl of Ishtar, or even a woman, though that would be mildly scandalous. What do you think? Should we go for the woman and go for scandal? Yep. As a queen, plus one pressured and willful, few would dare comment about your choice of companions, but until you've provided an heir to the throne, there is great pressure on you to make an appropriate match. That doesn't mean you have to give in. It might be entertaining to see the reaction of Juliana, Duchess of Ursel, if you asked her to dance with you. Would she be flustered for once? Bryn, the Duchess of Hellas, is an attractive and unmarried woman. You might think seeing the two of you together. According to rumour, she is inclined in that direction, but what does she think of you? Oh, who was that? Who was that one? That was the second one. The most important woman present after yourself is Arissa, Duchess of Lila. She is married, elderly, a mother and grandmother many times over. She might be flattered by the acknowledgement of her status. Or if you truly wanted to set the court on its ear, you could demand your first dance with a mere servant, a maid like Alice. The assembled nobles would be outraged. I like it. Alice! Have the maid Alice brought here. I wish to dance with her. Excellent. All sound in the room stops, save for a little Adair's nervous laughter. Still, you've given a royal command, and thus someone goes to find the maid. A few minutes later, Alice is pushed out into the glittering throng by a pair of burly manservants. If you insist, I can use the scroll wheel. Oh, okay. If you insist, my lady. Dutifully, she places her hand in yours. Dancing with a real partner feels quite different from dancing with your father. You knew him, knew his steps as part of you. Now your every move is a mystery, and I failed dancing. As soon as you relax your grip, the maid flees to the safety of the kitchens. Between the dances, there's time for guests to mingle, chat, and sample tiny bites of exquisite food. Court manners and flattery. During a lull in the music, Banyan, the Duke of Marie, taps an elegant fingernail against a wine glass, letting a clear note ring out through the room. If I might have your attention. I believe we should offer our compliments to our lovely hostess. Her bravery and courage keep our borders defended. Everyone applauds politely. As the gala continues, you take the opportunity to observe nobles that you rarely see. There's Gwynell, for instance, the young lady of Sudbury, only months older than you, and you two finally inherit control of her duchy soon. Or Edel, the youngest daughter of the Duchess of Lila and a fierce sportswoman. She's a few years ahead of you at school and an absolute terror of the ball fields. No Bryony. She had said her parents were leaving her stuck at school this season. Her parents are here, dancing together, the Duke consort clutching his Duchess possessively tight. Strange that there's no sign of your cousins, though. Shouldn't they be here? Your aunt and uncle are here, of course. It'd be scandalous if they hadn't come, Merva being so close by. Sense magic failed. Ooh. It's nice to be able to enjoy time with the friends and family, isn't it? Okay, if you say so. Probably still not going to get anywhere with that one. Yielding to press. I need to get cheerful. Have I got to just keep playing with my damned toys until I become cheerful? That's really annoying. Cheerful. I want to get cheerful. Thank you. Okay, so. We need to get trade over to 25 so that we can increase accounting. So do trade first and then accounting. Yes, indeed. Trade and then accounting. Trade, accounting. You learn that individual peddlers travel between villages and cities, some on foot with packs and mules, others riding horses and wagons. Sometimes different wagons group together to form a caravan. The most important trade route in the domain is the Kavala River. It travels through the centre of your lands, and almost every duchy contains tributaries that feed into the Kavala, allowing goods to be shipped along it by boat. Morning. You learn that the individual peddlers travel between villages and cities and work on foot with packs and mules, others riding horses and wagons. Sometimes different wagons group together to form a caravan. The most important trade route in the domain is the Kavala River. Haven't I already? I've unlocked a new outfit. Okay, you learn about the concept of diminishing returns. A point after winning more on a particular project fails to improve it as much as previous spending did. You study taxation and learn about how past monarchs demanded too much and drove peasants into ruin in order to collect it. Or the monarchs demanding too little and drove whole domains into ruin by lacking the funds to sustain and defend them. I get a new outfit, though. I've got a new outfit. You wander downstairs to visit your father and talk about the latest events in the domain. You're moving with such enthusiasm that you don't realize your father isn't alone until it's too late to avoid him and his companion. You're too kind, Jocelyn. Okay. Countess Cyrin, not a member of your circles, she's a bit more than a decade your senior, far too old to have ever been your friend, and yet not at all old as noble women go. She has two minor titles, no husband, and your father's arm in her grasp. How dare she make a move on your father? Why? Who cares? Shame her with silent scorn. Insult her with false flattery. Trip her as she... What? Are you flipping kidding me? You meet her eyes and imagine your mother's disapproving presence behind you. She notices your stare, but she only smiles at you ever so sweetly. Darling Elodie, I hope you have been well. Fine. Perhaps we'll be seeing more of each other in... Do I have to call you Mummy now? She gives a little wave and exits. Once she's gone, you raise an eyebrow at your father. Don't give me that look, young lady. She's a nice woman, nothing more. She wants something more. And it's not going to happen anytime soon. You should be careful how you deal with people like Cyrin. You need the goodwill of your nobles as well as your commoners. There haven't been any problems so far. Many dark looks were aimed at your way at the gala. As queen, you must be aware of everything around you. Isn't that what I have agents for? Intrigue! See? Yes, but you must give them direction. What is your greatest concern? Noble plots. commoner uprisings, foreign threats, assassins. No, it's noble plots. I need to know what the other nobles are up to and whether anyone is plotting behind my back. As you wish. Okay. So, I'm still going for the whole cheerfulness, or could I now visit the... Assess! You overwhelm the guards with facts and figures, explaining that you need treasury access to adjust the royal budget, which may affect their pay packets, as well as the taxes assessed on their friends and family. They stand aside. Plus one willful. The glitter is dull as dazzling, but some sixth sense draws you towards one little lockbox in particular. This is what you need. This is the crystal that will make you a lumen. Whatever the hell a lumen is. You tuck the box into your pocket. You can show it to your mentor later and get instructions on what to do next. Okay, did I get a new outfit? Boosts intrigue, boosts economics. Oh, look at that. Here we go. What's my mood? My mood is angry. But really, I'm having difficulty with the whole cheerful thing, aren't I? I'm really having... On the bright side, my economics is now fair. Fair to good. My military is great. My intrigue's not so bad. Could do with getting a bit better. What else? Conversation plus 4-4. Public speaking and flattery seems to be something that I could do with getting better at. Yes, indeed. But at the same time, I sort of think from the sheer looking at the numbers thing here, I should focus on maximizing certain... Is there real... Can I now... I still have faith. Okay, no. I tell you what, let's just go for military. And let's finish off my military training. Let's get logistics and strategy pummeled out there. Logistics and strategy. You study how to determine when to jettison or destroy excess goods for speed and how to avoid overreaching. You learn about how to calculate enemy war preparations based upon the movement of goods within their lands. Armies do not spring up full formed overnight. You study the benefits of looting as a troop motivator versus the negative effect on civilian populations. So I'm getting bloody good at this war thing. You study the effects of a strong hider. 99.5. Communication. Oh, look at this. You study famous battles, the disasters and the mistakes which created them, and the turning points in larger conflicts, and why they made a difference. Awesome! It's time of the year to decide any necessary adjustments to the royal budget. The majority of the money we receive is already spoken for, but there is always some room for discretion. Accounting success. Based upon the records and notes of current expenditures, if you maintain the current tax rate, you will still have 9,995 gold lassi and 72 silver talassi available for special projects. You can't imagine any reason that you would need to spend so much. You can afford to lower taxes. Logistics success. 4,000 lassi should be enough to cover any military surprises for the rest of the year. Any little trade disruption shouldn't need more than a few hundred lassi to sort out, or at least temporarily. This my trade. Lower the taxes, right? That's gonna. We don't need. I think we have enough money. Let's lower the taxes a little, as you wish. Was that good? Okay. Oh, I'll work it. I didn't raise a chat. Right. I want cheerful. I want bloody cheerful. Or, I could visit Juliana, Duchess of Ursel. Yes, I could. I'll be back in a second, taking a quick break, gonna grab a drink. Okay, so we're going off to see Juliana, Duchess of Ursel. I got it! What do I do now? Pick up the crystal with your bare hands, press it against your chest, over your heart, and say, illuminate. Do it. Okay, here we go. Illuminate. Okay, just when I was starting to hate the game a little less. I got an achievement, though. You feel dizzy and both larger and lighter than you were before. The crystal has disappeared from view, and you know where it is. Wow. The priestess here is a friend of mine. I will come to your lessons in the faith and train you to use your powers.
Yes!
So we can now learn magic. I like it. So, still not getting cheerful, though. Still not on the whole cheerful thing. But we now have Lumen. Right. And what else? Naval strategy is my last military option. So let's finish that off. Finish the morning, and then go for Lumen. Wield magic.
Yes, indeed.
You study the cost, time, materials required to construct new ships. You study blockades, both setting them and breaking them. You study the effect of cannons against coastal installations such as enemy docks and seaside villages. Go to war with me, someone! Go to war with me! You lure into some of the small glowing light, which you can then move around independently. Sounds really useful. You know, I might get trapped in the dark. You are requested to stand judgment. A man has been convicted of the murder by strangling of his wife. He does not deny the act, but requests a pardon that he might be set free. If you admit you killed your wife, why do you think I'm going to set you free? Say me, your majesty, it wasn't my fault. Demons made me do it. Everyone knows the power of magical beasties. They used me. They twisted my fingers into chains. My wife found me screaming as she tried to shake me, and the chains wrapped around her. I need the priestess to bless me and make me clean again. Magic sense failed. Demons that make you attack people. Is that even possible? Imprison him. Well, maybe we'll find out later on. Whether there were demons or not, you still killed your wife. I won't forgive you for that. You'll be imprisoned for the rest of your life. He opens his mouth to argue with you further, but then his shoulders slump. Yes, your majesty. Okay, right. Mood. So, cheerful! Please, cheerful. Yeah, lonely again. Okay. Yielding, lonely, and cheerful, you spend the weekend playing with bloody toys. Condemned a man to life imprisonment, then played with my teddy bear. Okay. Still. Alright. Court manners. My court manners could do with some work, definitely. And this is the other option. I could keep focusing on either trade to become a real trade meister or intrigue. And I'm thinking it's time for intrigue. Go for intrigue. Do internal affairs. I really do want to get better at internal affairs. And how do I get better at this? What does sense magic. Oh, I sort of don't want to spend points in something where I'm not getting the bonus boost, you see. It's almost better to sort of bump up things like this, but I don't know how the hell to get my mystical powers better. I really don't. Alright, let's do sense magic as well, then. Willful boosts your magic, so I need willful for magic. Alright, thank you. I might stop training magic until I get my willful bonus up. It's just yielding seems to be better for all the other bloody skills. Countess of Dis is now married to the disinherited third. The Countess of Dis is now married to the disinherited third sibling of the Duke of Marie and the Duchess of Hellas. Currently, both Duke and Duchess are unwed. If either dies without heir, a title may still pass to the Countess's husband. Several generations back, the rulers of Elath and Sedna in neighbouring Talassi married. The citizens of Elath objected to this foreign influence, and the resulting heir died in suspicious circumstances, after which the title was passed to a distant branch of the family rather than another child of the Elath-Sedna union. You close your eyes and feel, and learn to feel the magic inside you. Okay. You received a word that the murderer you condemned to prison has escaped. A large explosion rocked the jail he was in, destroying the walls and setting many dangerous criminals free. What? It will now fall to the Royal Treasury to repair the damage.
Brilliant.
All right, so I need to be willful, not yielding, but yielding is what gets me the bonuses in the other bloody things. So I need to be willful and cheerful, or I need to not focus on magic for now. Willful is the opposite of you, right, so... It depends, what do I want to actually focus on? I'm going to keep focusing on yielding. I'm going to focus on some of the other skills that I need. You spend the weekend holed up alone in your room, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, we got that. Right. So let's have a look. My mood is now... We're getting towards a bit more cheerful and yielding. So I'm hoping now... Bonus is here. That's what I'm looking for. I'd like to get public speaking, flattery, and court manners up. Or do I? Logistics. Right, we're gonna finish off with logistics, I think. On the military side of things. Now, I'm gonna... intellectual seems to favour willful, doesn't it? Social seems to favour yielding. Should I just forget court manners and flattery? Just go for absolute intellectual domination, willfulness, and blow everyone to small smithereens? I'm sort of feeling like that's the way to go here. No subtlety, all in. All right then, let's just go for... Logistic. Oh, this is what if I no, wait. Oh yeah, if I use the current classes I've got. No, that's not it at all. If I use logistics, what does this mean? What when I'm wearing this uniform, does that mean? Oh, whoa. It doesn't boost how much I learn, it actually boosts my ability in that area. Right, I think I got it now. So if I'm wearing this uniform, for example, I get artificially enhanced here. If I wear the military uniform... So I don't actually need to wear the military uniform because... I see. Huh. I thought it helped me train up more. I see now that was incorrect. So, then logistics and... Ciphering. Logistics and ciphering. I'm becoming like a warrior spy master. Okay. You practice complex transposition ciphers, you practice adding code to your ciphers, and you memorize special cipher alphabets. And then in the afternoon, you learn to calculate how effective military strength wanes over distance from a home position as it becomes more difficult to put pieces into play. You learn how to delay the advance of an invading force by disrupting their transport and communications. You have nothing more to learn about logistics. Excellent. I regret to inform you that Fabian, the Earl of Titan and Duke Regent of Eloth, has passed away. This isn't really a surprise, he was pretty old. The problem is the political implications. With the control of Eloth in doubt, it falls to the crown to make decisions. Young Lord Adair will not reach his 15th birthday for over 2 years. He requires a regent. His stepmother, Arissa, the Duchess of Lila, has petitioned that the boy be left in her care. This would, however, leave her in personal control of two neighbouring duchies, which is generally forbidden. Okay, almost the entire eastern border. I don't know anything really bad about her, though. Okay, so I'm really bad at history. I need to get my history up. The boy does have a living grandfather, the Earl of Ishtar, or you might appoint an unrelated noble to act in his stead. It does occur to me that training up in military at this point was probably a bad idea, because I haven't gone to war enough. I'm just not using my skills. The boy does have a living grandfather, the Earl of Ishtar, or you might appoint an unrelated noble to act in his stead. The Earl of Ishtar has suggested another possibility. You and Adair are both young, not too far apart in age. He requests that we accept the boy as your future husband and keep him here at the castle. Why do I want to marry him? I don't marry him. I do not want to marry him. Send him to your uncle, send him to his grandfather. Grandfather! There you go. He should be the regent. As you wish. Right. Mood. What were we going for? Yielding and cheerful for... No, we're just going for willful, aren't we? We've just said to this. Let's just go for magic skills. What about history? What's the best thing for history? It's not going to tell me, is it? Willful, pressured. That one, wasn't it? Okay, willful it is. Skills. I should learn some history, you see. I'm thinking I should learn some history. Internal affairs. Bit. I'm going to boost trade. I'm going to boost trade and production. Yes, I am. Trade and production. I'm currently too angry. So I need to reduce my anger. Okay. That I didn't realize. Much of the domain's trade comes in from the Western Ocean. The capital city and your castle are located on the island near the mouth of Kavala River, where it meets the sea. That makes this the most important location for trade in the domain. The second most important seaport in the domain is Ursulia, on the Theku Bay. Ursul is the only duchy with no access to the Kavala River. They send their goods south to you by ship. You learn that most of the domain's iron is mined in Sudbury and transported west by the Gowain River to the Kavala. You learn that the hilly terrain in Hellas is no good for growing most crops, but is excellent for vineyards and migratory flocks of sheep and goat. Brilliant. There's a woman here to see you. She's a musician and wishes the crown's patronage, which means money. Your Royal Highness, if you accept me as a member of your court, I will immortalize you in word and song. I've dabbled in musical styles from many countries and can entertain your guests and lighten your evenings. Foreign intelligence failed, intrigue success. Musicians are often used as secret agents and messengers. They can be useful and dangerous. The musician sings a little ditty to demonstrate her skills with the lute. Instrument plus voice failed. She's actually pretty good. Accept her as... Yes! Very well, you can remain as part of the court. She's going to stab me in the back and kill me. I will do my best for you. All right. Mood. I need to get afraid and willful. Afraid and willful. I can't do both, can I? I can go for willful, but I... Afraid and depressed. No, see, lonely's not so bad, actually. Afraid and yielding. Minus one angry. That sounds a bit... Visit the dungeons, yielding and afraid. Or lonely and afraid. Let's explore the castle, we've not done that before. You wander through the parts of the castle where other people rarely visit, but find little except spiderwebs. Yuck. Seriously, yuck. Alright, so a little less angry. And a bit more lonely. Still nothing. However, increasing our intrigue seems to be the way to go. Let's... Because... Right now, we've got a big boost here. Big. This is actually increasing as well. This is increasing, so we're heading in the right direction. But right now, intrigue. Let's go for internal affairs and foreign intelligence. Yes, indeed. Internal affairs and foreign intelligence. There we go, we're getting pretty good at internal affairs. There were many dark rumours about the second husband of the Duchess of Lila, and possibly because he was a commoner. It was whispered that he once assaulted the young Duchess of Elath before her untimely marriage and demise. After years of marriage and three children, the Duchess of Lila divorced her second husband and refused to say why. Shortly afterwards, he was found dead in a nearby forest. The Duchess of Lila and her son, the Earl of Io, have been estranged ever since. The Earl of Io, or Low, I'm not sure there's an L, now lives with his sister, the Duchess of Mead. Afternoon. Foreign intelligence. Rumour has it that the mother and the older sister of the last Duchess of Elath were assassinated 20 years ago by agents of Sedna, which is why she, the sole remaining heir, was married off so young. Rumour has it that the Prince of Tenax was humiliated by the public dissolution of his betrothal to an heiress after she declared him a coward. The Queen of Shangia is wedded to a non-noble, a court musician whom she initially took as a consort, barring any offspring from inheriting the throne. She has since passed new laws to give her not only their children, but also the man himself, an equal claim to the clown. Clown. Brilliant. Crown. You received a letter from young Lord Adair. It's an extremely formal letter for such a little boy, thanking you for your wisdom in allowing him to live with his grandfather, who probably dictated every word he wrote. You also receive an update from your agents. It would seem that the Duchess of Lila is not pleased with your actions, and she is putting out feelers amongst the other nobles for support. If she means to rebel against you, that is treason. Unfortunately, she's a long way away in her own power base. Calling her to order may not be easy. Still, the longer you wait, the more dangerous she may become. Send assassins to kill her. Wait for more information. Send assassins to kill her. You give orders for assassins to arrange for a quiet, natural-looking demise. She's not a young woman, and she's just lost her husband. It shouldn't be suspicious. Yes, excellent. Right, get a bit more cheerful. We want to get a bit more afraid, though. We need to be afraid and willful. Afraid and willful. That's yielding. Wrong. That was afraid, but it's... That's afraid. Afraid and willful. Okay, explore the castle again. Depressed and afraid. I've not visited... Let's visit this. I just want to visit everywhere. You pay your respects to your mother's tomb and wonder if the same fate is waiting for you. What death? Of course it is. Or can I become immortal? That's an interesting idea. So I'm right on the back. My anger's coming down. So I need to get anger down. Willful up. Anger down. Willful up. Okay. Skills. Ciphering is really the only thing less than 90 in my intrigue area. So I'm thinking we go for production and ciphering. Yes, I do. You study an ancient book that has a list of 1,000 words and pictograms for each of them. In the past, these were used for important messages, but only trained bards could effectively memorize enough symbols to handle the codes efficiently. You learn to manipulate special boxes and jewelry with the secret compartments to hide messages. A rare few have locks, almost as complicated as the ciphers themselves. Afternoon. You learn that gold and other precious minerals are mined in the mountains of Elath. You learn that wool from Hellas travels north to cotton-growing Mead, where quality cloth is created and dyed. You learn that sand from Marie travels north to Caloris, where it is crafted into glass. And while studying the reports... Oh, logistics and trade! While studying the reports of trade and goods shipments, you notice something interesting. The domain of Shangia, which is now the major power on the western continent, appears to be stepping up production. In particular, their increased demand for wool, hemp, linen, and metals suggest that they are producing new ships and new weapons. This could be the precursor to a war fleet. World history failed. Foreign affairs. Hey, oh god, my history sucks. Shangia lies in a great distance from Nova. You have a few diplomatic ties and no known conflicts. There is no reason to assume that it would be their target. Still, if they send a fleet across the ocean, Nova might be in danger. At the very least, shipping would be disrupted. Trade. Partial success. My trade's not that good. Okay. The Western Ocean is very important to Novan trade and could cause problems. It takes time to assemble worthy vessels and you have advanced warning. You could make your own preparations to defend your coast. The downside is they won't come cheap. Build more warships. You send all orders for assembly of new ships and the strengthening of weaponry and cladding on the existing fleet. If trouble comes, you'll be ready for it. You receive word that the Duchess of Lila has passed away quietly in her sleep. Yes. At least that is what everybody thinks. She left her title not to the Earl of Low, but to Kieran, one of her youngest sons. Younger sons. He's 19 and rather handsome, as you recall. Everything has turned out for the best. Yes. Okay, so we're still going for less angry and more willful. Less angry, more willful. This would balance that, but where else have we not been? We've not been to a service yet. We've not been to a service. We've not been to the dungeons, I don't think. And we've not walked around the garden. Or have we? I don't know. Let's go to the service. You attend services in the castle grove, letting the peace of the ritual calm your heart. Because my anger's going down. My anger's going down. And I'm lonely. Lonely, that's my current mood. My current mood is lonely. Oh, so I only ever have one mood then. And it's whatever's the max, right? It's whatever the max is. Is that how it works? Still no. Yeah. Mind you, oh, look at this. Public speaking and flattery. .44. Might see my trade's pretty good at the moment, and I'm wearing the trade suit. I kind of want to go for the ciphering even more, just to make sure I'm really. No, I tell you what, public speaking, and flattery. It is public speaking, and flattery. Up your history, that's currently where you screw up. I know, but I've got no bonuses in history at the moment. So if whatever I do, I get very little bonus for it. So I get more benefit from going things that have got current bonuses. You practice tongue-twisting sequences of syllables to improve your enunciation. Afternoon, you learn that it's more important to make eye contact when saying nice things about someone. Okay. See, in doing this, I get slightly better at dealing with people. I have unpleasant news to report. Adair, the young Lord of Elath, has been assassinated. Okay. What? Plus one afraid! He was shot with a crossbow while playing on the grounds of his grandfather's estate. How did this happen? Where were the guards? This is not the first time such events have happened within the realm of Ishtar. The Earl of Ishtar's first wife and eldest daughter also died under mysterious circumstances. Officially an accident, but there are rumours it was agents from Talasi. Then his other daughter married young and died, giving birth to Adair. Gopher, I would not think you for someone who would speak in public. Okay, interesting. Pseudophozops said, it's not that complicated. I guess you never paper-padded a D&D long-term level 1 campaign. I'm assuming you're not talking to me. I'm assuming you're not talking to me because, yes, not only have I played a lot of D&D, I've played an awful lot of pen and paper RPGs, and I haven't done it for a decade and a half, 2 decades, but yes, I played a lot of pen and paper RPGs, and in fact, the last 4 or 5 years that I was playing was pretty much almost exclusively as a game master. Then his other daughter married young and died, giving birth to Adair. Okay, with Adair dead, the only family he has left is his second wife and their son, Connor, who's 15. Blame the Earl of Ishtar. Blame Talassi. Blame no one. No matter what we do, things keep going wrong. Then there is the matter of the Duchy of Alath. By blood, the nearest living heir is Talaris, the Duke of Sedna in Talassi. Internal affairs. A long time ago, there were marriages between the leaders of Alath and Sedna. That's his ancestry. But the people of Alath did not want a duke of foreign blood. There were revolts. The title of Duke of Alath was passed to a distant relative instead of Talarist's ancestor. Alath is a major duchy. You cannot afford to lose control of it. There are important mining operations there. We need those resources. Shall we name a Novenair? Yeah, let's do it. As queen, I have the right to pass the lands of the extinct bloodline to a new ruler. Like my mother did with Uncle Laurent and Nerva. Talaris is only distantly related and he's foreign. He doesn't count. Who should inherit the Duchy of Alath then? There are a few nobles with a lot of children. Too many to inherit all the existing titles. Arissa, the old Duchess of Lila, had 6 children and most of them have titles. The oldest are Kevin, the Earl of Low, Corisanda, the Duchess of Mead, and Charmion, the Duchess consort of Kigal. Then there's 3 more around my age, Ciaran, the new Duke of Lila, his brother Thaddeus, and his sister Adele. The Duke and Duchess of Kigal have 7 children, 3 around my age and 4 younger. They're all Arissa's grandchildren through their mother, so either way it would be her line. How do I go back? Okay, let's... The Duke and Duchess of Kigal have 7 children. And they're all Arissa's grandchildren through their mother, so either way it would be her line. Child from the Duke of Kigal. Oh, I have no idea. The Duke of Kigal has so many children, let him pick one for Alath. Very well. Don't know if that was a good idea, but... Right, I want to go for willful now. I'm trying to get willful and willful... Oh, but that'll also increase lonely. Yielding and afraid. I said I was going to go along to... I want to visit everywhere I've not visited, so we're going to the dungeons. Affected by yieldiness, yield and afraid, you creep through the castle dungeons, catching glimpses here and there of the fate that awaits troublemakers in this kingdom. Even nobles can end up here sometimes. It's a good reminder to stay on the straight and narrow. Okay, my mood is now yieldiness. Okay. Still lonely, but I'm not afraid anymore. Now, we really do need to get willfulness bumped up a little bit. Let's have a look at the skills. Conversation is getting really... This is because I've become yielding, you see. Because I've become yielding, I'm better at this. Public speaking. So I'm better with people. I'm still not very good with history. I don't quite know... Yeah. Bonus to conversation and medicine. Penalty to royal demeanor, intrigue, and faith. See, I'm not getting any bonuses on this one. And that's what I want. I want bonuses. I like bonuses. So I'm thinking public speaking. Just keep going for public speaking. Let's get better at those. Conversation, public speaking, and flattery still. Okay, blah, 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 blah. Right, that's increased. And this is increased. Get a sore throat from reading all these things. You have unlocked a new outfit, have I? I've got a new outfit, guys. I have more unpleasant news. I'm beginning to really, really not like you, Dad. You just saying. I know I shouldn't shoot the messenger, but... Soldiers from Talassi have crossed the border into Elath and are pushing towards the ducal seat. The Duke of Sedna insists that he is the rightful heir and the territory belongs to him. Your newly appointed Duke requests additional military support and supplies. Sigh, plus one pressured. Fine, whatever. Whatever! Another letter from Brownie. Why does she keep writing me? We were never even friends. She says she's bored and lonely, and she's looking forward to seeing me again at Gwenelle's birthday party. That's right, Gwenelle is about to turn 15. She'll be the Duchess of Sudbury for real now. This other letter must be my invitation to her birthday celebration next week. Gwenelle and I were friends at school, and this will be a big event, but it's also a long way to travel. A lot of things can happen on the road. We're going. Divination failed. It'll be good to see my friends, plus one cheerful. Okay, let's have a look at my mood. My mood is cheerful-ish, yielding. Right, so. Yielding is what's giving me the bonuses to the speaking skills. Right, the only place we've not been so far is lonely and cheerful. Let's walk in the gardens. A walk in the fresh air helps you forget the burdens on your shoulders. Did it? Right, what's my new outfit? Give me a new outfit, my new outfit. Tea dress boosts conversation. Okay, right. Oh, we don't actually need that. We need the economics one. The economics is where we're most in need. Yep. That, oh god though, look at it, I'm getting a massive boost here. I am getting a massive boost. The only thing I've got even close to as big a boost on that is military. Okay. Looks like conversation is it. We're sticking with conversation again because it is just so damned useful. And we're going to a party soon. We're going to a party. So you know what we need? We need to be able to hold ourselves well at the party. Okay, visual elements are the best to flatter on first meeting. They are expected to be noticed right away. If you spent more time with someone, suddenly complimenting their attire will ring false. Small personal details help make the recipient of your flattery feel like you have truly noticed them, which is always better than a simple, how nice you look. Afternoon. You memorize the correct title for every servant in the castle. Treating servants with respect ensures good service. To directly challenge someone's honor is to declare war. Never make a public accusation of cowardice, treason, infidelity, or murder unless you're prepared to face mortal enemies. And on that note, you study etiquette of dueling. Okay, on your journey to Sudbury, your carriage is attacked by bandits. Archery reflexes failed, plus three of... Okay, you look down in shock at the arrow, which has buried itself in your side. Outside, you hear screams and curses, but it feels unreal. Your world is centered around pain. Okay, battlefield medicine failed. You struggle with the arrow, afraid to pull it loose. You heard a story somewhat about pushing arrows through the body, so you brace yourself and give it a shove. That's a very bad idea. Unfortunately, this only drives the arrow deeper into your vital organs, turning a painful wound into a fatal one. Oh, you're kidding me! Oh my god! Okay. Okay. So, I'm guessing then, the rule for this game is do not go to any parties or engagements unless you've got combat skills and or medicine skills. So, you can't travel. You can't travel. If you're going to focus on the skills I focused on, stay in your castle. Stay in your castle. Okay. you are dead. Not a big surprise, says Zathan Drawn. Oh, let me guess. I'm the world's worst player at, what was it? Long Live the Queen. You know what? Guilty is charged. Yes, I'm sure you played it and didn't die first time. okay, here's the thing though, guys. I've been playing this for over 2 hours. And I'm gonna let you into the weirdest secret. I don't hate it. Zelfos, you are pardoned. You have earned a reprieve. The headsman does not have a job today. I didn't actually hate that. I don't like the style. I really don't. I'm not a big lover of the pink. Not a big lover of the eyeballs. But the actual core game itself is oddly fun. It is actually strangely fun, which is weird. It is just a more complicated version of Kingdom. So the big question is, does anybody know what Kingdom is? Probably not. You can all Google it. There is a game for a computer called the BBC Model B computer. It's a pretty old computer, and this game was called Kingdom. And all you did was tweak three variables: how many men you put on the dikes, how many men you put on defense, and how many men you had working the fields. And you changed the numbers and altered them year by year, and then it played out. This is just a much more complicated version of that. It's a kingdom management game where you're not building. It's not like SimCity management or Warcraft city management with battles and things. You're purely administering the results. And I actually quite like those sort of games. So, there you go. Oddly enough, that was not the worst game I've ever played. Congratulations on your recent demise. Ella Dee did not survive to reach her coronation. Nova would have to go on without her, but it doesn't have to end this way. Make different choices, train different skills, and Ella Dee's star may rise again. I'm going to tell you this. I may actually play this again. Probably not on stream. Well, maybe on stream as well. Oddly enough, I kind of have this urge to beat this game. Isn't that the oddest thing? Is that not the oddest thing? Title screen, show log, load game. We don't load game. What? You want me to save scum? How dare you? How dare? But what is with what? Seriously, why? Why? The core game wasn't too bad, but why? Okay. I can't believe 500 people have watched me play. I don't even know what to call this style game, anime or whatever it is. Okay. I've not seen Cupcake in the in the chat. I would have thought this was the sort of game for her. But there you go. Right. Apparently it's a Japanese game, hence the reason it looks like this. Why the hell are they playing the British national anthem? Magical Princess Simulator. That's just... Have you just missed the stream? You did! I died. It's an extremely underestimated game. Yes, it probably is. I have to tell you, though, that's a self-inflicted wound. That is a self-inflicted wound. Yeah, obviously, that's my cultural bias. But with slightly different visuals, this game would probably have been more popular. And I wonder how difficult it would have been to change the visuals, just have two different sets, one for different audiences. But oddly enough, the core game concept is not that bad. The whole love hearts and stuff, though, it's a bit kind of... You only died once. I only played once. I stopped. Oh, dear.